This billionaire might be the most successful tech investor you've never heard of. And that's on purpose. Before this year, the last time he made it into the news was by accident, holding a private party with his wife and celebrity friends like Paris Hilton to celebrate the renovations to his exclusive Upper East Side apartment. But he was so successful last year that he couldn't avoid the press any longer. Which begs the question, how did Chase Coleman make $3 billion last year? Is there a billionaire you can't wait for Portfolio Insider to deep dive? Drop a comment down below. The story of Chase Coleman's $3 billion haul last year starts with how he turned a $25 million seed into a $50 billion fund. Hired by legendary hedge fund pioneer Julian Robertson Jr. in 1999, Coleman got to learn under one of the best. Julian Robertson preached a simple philosophy of buying the best companies and shorting the worst. Over 60 hedge fund managers like Stephen Mandel Jr. of Lone Pine Capital, John Griffin of Blue Ridge Capital, O. Andreas Halverson of Viking Capital, Philippe Lafont of Coteau Management, and Lee Ansley III of Maverick Capital can all be traced back to Robertson and are now known as Tiger Cubs in the industry. In 2001, following the dot-com crash, Tiger Management closed to outside investors. Robertson said in an interview a year later, "I don't believe much in tech. It is not the place to be." Yet he funded protege Chase Coleman's tech fund anyway. Looking back, Coleman wrote, "It did not seem like the opportune time to start a firm initially dubbed Tiger Technology, but it was our chance and we were determined to make the most of it." 20 years later, Tiger Global Management is one of the most successful hedge funds in the world. Coleman has earned investors over $26.5 billion, according to LCH Investments. How did he do it? In his 20th anniversary letter to shareholders, Coleman said by seeking to identify high-quality businesses levered to the most important secular growth trends while shorting poorly positioned companies on the wrong side of change. In particular, Coleman identified the success of venture capital investing as one of the major secular growth trends. In order to get in even earlier, Tiger Global supplements its traditional hedge fund bets with private equity funds that invest in startups pre-IPO. Two of their most recognizable wins were Postmates' all-stock sale to Uber for $2.65 billion and Credit Karma's $7 billion sale in cash and stock to Intuit. Last year, Tiger Global raised a $3.75 billion venture fund that rivaled even the biggest venture capital firms. This year, their Tiger Private Investment Partners, 14, raised a record $6.75 billion fund, surpassing Silicon Valley VC stalwarts like Lightspeed Venture Partners and their $4 billion fund, and even Andreessen Horowitz's two $4.5 billion funds. Industry observers note how fast Coleman and his team move to complete deals. Tiger Global can close a funding round in just 3 days, a process that typically takes other firms months. They identified funding targets like Peloton, ServiceTitan, and Coinbase and offered money before the companies were even looking for it. Coleman's fund owned 20% of Peloton in 2019 when they IPO'd. Just in the past year, Peloton is up over 140%, and Portfolio Insider last tracked him holding almost 8 million shares. Big international wins include turning a $3 billion profit on Flipkart in India and making over $1 billion from service booking platform Meituan Jiangping. And these venture investments frequently turned into publicly held shares in the Tiger Global portfolio. JD.com has been one of the company's biggest winners of all time. Chase Coleman initially invested $200 million and is up over $5 billion on the Chinese e-commerce giant so far. JD.com currently makes up to 11.63% of Tiger Global Management's portfolio. Despite China's recent crackdown on tech giants, JD looks like a great value, trading at a PE of just 14.36, with Portfolio Insider projecting 34.88% revenue growth in 2021 and a 54% jump in earnings per share in 2022. Tiger Global Management also first funded Roblox in a 2018 venture round, along with VC firms like Greylock. Not only did they already own 10% before the company went public on March 10th, they liked the company so much that they bought up another $2.62 billion worth of shares after the opening bell that day. Since their IPO 2 months ago, Roblox is already up over $20 and 25% from their $65 initial offering. And in the first quarter of 2021, the gaming platform added 87% more users outside their core US and Canada markets, while daily active users over the age of 13 increased 111%. Morgan Stanley analyst Brian Nowak said, "This continued user engagement and bookings growth should give investors more confidence in the durability of Roblox's forward growth and free cash flow potential." Microsoft anchors the Tiger Global portfolio. Coleman first opened the position in 2016 and increased the number of shares in the first quarter of this year by 16%. Microsoft now makes up 7.35% of their overall portfolio, with their holdings valued at $3.23 billion. Since 2016, the blue-chip tech giant is up 423.36% and hasn't missed earnings expectations once. Year-to-date, they're up 10%, with Azure Cloud Services driving much of the growth in recent years. The last major investment Coleman made in the first quarter of 2021 was to the Tiger Global philanthropic venture. Mentor Julian Robertson strongly advocated that Tiger management employees allocate a portion of capital to the less fortunate, having created the Tiger Foundation and his Robertson Foundation. Inside Philanthropy noted that Chase Coleman and his wife have given to causes like KIPP New York Schools, the Boys Club of New York, and the New York Presbyterian Hospital. And just like his mentor, Chase Coleman's star managers are starting funds of their own. Lee Fixel, who spearheaded the Flipkart deal in India, started the VC Fund Edition. Karthik Sarma oversees SRS Investment Management, which now manages $5 billion. And Chen Xiaohong now runs H Capital Venture Fund, one of the largest run by a woman. According to Adam Tabak, the private wealth chief investment officer at Wells Fargo, when people spin out from Tiger Global, investors know they have been well-trained, that they have demonstrated success, and that they often have backers that follow them to their new shop. After reaching $26.5 billion returned to investors since 2001, Chase Coleman's Tiger Global Management now ranks 14th all-time among hedge funds. Portfolio Insider estimates just the top 20 hedge funds have generated over $500 billion in returns. So click subscribe and hit the alarm bell to keep up with all of their top holdings.